Hi, I'm Anne Swan, and this is a brief guide to my new Creative Colour Mixing Workbook. This is an aid to help you with your layering and building up vibrant colours, and also to create greater depth in your work and to plan ahead so that you know exactly what goes into your mixes before you jump into your picture. And it hopefully will prevent lots of accidents or potential accidents. After a brief introduction, I describe some of the basic techniques. So the core skill for coloured pencil, I think, is the ability to lay down a smooth layer of colour, varying your pressure where you want full saturation to light saturation. So for this swatch, I've used a Faber-Castell 134, and I've pressed very heavily on this end of the bar and gradually decreased the pressure until I've got to light as light can be this end. So using little ellipses, changing direction and working over the surface of the paper, turning the point of the pencil when it begins to wear down and sharpening frequently. And with practice, you'll be able to achieve this really smooth lay down of colour. And there are several little spaces here where you can practice that technique. And then there are some descriptions of some of the basic techniques, layering and underpainting and so on. There's a short bit about colour mixing and the colour wheel. And then there's some pages of templates for more complex colour layering with greater mixes, so up to 9 colours in your mix, and so on. But the most important thing, I think, is this basic colour layering, which is what I'm going to show you today. So I'm looking at these lovely bright Chinese lanterns, gorgeous rich orange colour, and I want to build up some nice colour. So first of all, I want to establish what colours I'm going to put into my mix. So here we have several circles for shading in, and the middle one is the main colour. So that is the colour that's closest to your subject matter. And in order to establish that, it's really useful to have some of these. If you go onto my website in the members area, you can download the blanks of these and colour them in at your leisure with the pencils that you have in your sets. So I'm starting off, for preference, with Faber-Castell Polychromos. So I'm looking at the oranges here, and I can see that the colour nearest to these Chinese lanterns is number 115, dark cadmium orange. So I'm going to write that underneath here. That's Faber-Castell 115. And then I need to choose a lighter colour and a darker colour. So for my darker colour, I think the nearest is 117, because that further on we move into these colours are too red. So I'm going to go with Faber-Castell 117. So that goes in my dark here, 117. And now I need a lighter colour. So 115. I'm going to skip up to 111, which is a nice rich yellow orange. 111. So that's going to be my lightest colour in my mix, I think. Right, so that gives me a good start, and I'm just going to lay these colours into these circles, pressing heavily and gently lightening the pressure until it's very, very soft and gentle. So feathering from dark to light. I'll speed this up so as not to bore you to death. Thank you. Now, I've got quite a nice mix here, but I think it needs brightening up a bit. Faber-Castell colours are excellent to work with, but they're not quite as punchy as some of the other makes. So I'm going to add in a slightly darker colour. This is pumpkin orange, and this is a prism colour. So the Prismacolor Pumpkin Orange is number 1032. And this last colour I added in was the Luminance. These are very expensive pencils, but the colours are lovely and rich and they do add something to a mix. So this is called it's called Cornelian, and it's number 850, so that's L850 going in there. So that's my mix. So all of those colours will be used somewhere, maybe the darker shades more in the shade area. But I now need a colour that will darken this mix in the shadows. And using the colour wheel that's in the book, I can establish or try and establish a colour that will do the job. So just flicking through to the further on in the book, this is the colour wheel page, and we can see here in the ready oranges that if you go across to the opposite colour, that's the complementary colour, it's a blue. Now, I don't think in colour pencil there's any place for a blue in here. If we used a blue, it would show through because the oranges are very translucent and we wouldn't be able to cover the blue up satisfactorily. So I'm going to move around the colour wheel towards the red violets, and I'm going to plump for something in this kind of area. So that's the crimson violet. And as I've done this before, I know that Faber-Castell Light Red Violet, number 135, is the perfect colour for shading these mid to dark oranges. So that goes in the end here in the shade colour circle. I'm only using a small amount because it's quite a dark colour and it only goes in the shadows, nowhere else. So just the shaded areas. So now we're going to mix these colours up together and see if it works. So on this final circle here, this is where you can mix these all together. And generally we work from dark to light. So I'm going to start with the shade colours and move through the darker colours. Then the main colour goes virtually everywhere except the very highlighted areas. And then the lighter, richer colours on top to finish. So my shade colour first, just where the shadows are. Thank you. each layer takes you a little further in towards the highlights. So when you come to actually draw the Chinese lantern, you would start off with the shadows to give the form and then start to build up your colours, gradually moving across the surface until you get to these lighter areas. So the next colour is Faber-Castell 117. So that gives me a nice finish. If you want to make the shadows a bit deeper, you can always go back in again with your darker colours and layer all the other colours up through on top to get your mix richer. I'm just going to make a note of what this is here. It's a Chinese lantern. January 2017. So there you have it. That's all there is to it. Choose your main colour and then choose some darker colours and some lighter, brighter colours to make your mix. And once you've got your mix, then you choose a shade colour that will give you depth in the shadows but not muddy your colour. So you want to keep the colour as bright as possible. And then you have a record of what you've done. And you can always refer back to that in years to come, and you know exactly how you achieved that really bright colour. Thank you for studying with me, and happy colouring in.